Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming to our talk. So we're from NTT Communications, and we're here to present about our topic under the operations track, and it's titled OpenStack Operation under a Multi-Tenant and Multi-Customer Public Cloud Environment. So just a quick introduction about ourselves.
I'm Yuta Hono, mainly working for the operation tool and the support tool design and development.
I'm Koji Hota. I'm working for the Apache Server Services Enterprise Public Cloud, especially for the Nova.
And I'm Charles Siloy, and I'm mainly working for infrastructure management. So this will be the outline of our presentation. So we will have an introduction, then we will present the requirements of our service, and then we will present the challenges that we faced and how we solved them, and we will present an actual use case and demo. And finally, we'll wrap up this presentation. Now, regarding the introduction, I'd like to emphasize that we will be explaining about the business background of our service, because it's important in order for us to understand the requirements of our service. So introduction, just a quick rundown on where we come from. We come from NTT Group, and NTT is actually the one that won the Super User Award last summit in Tokyo. Oh. And under NTT, we come from NTT Communications. And just some numbers, NTT Group is one of the largest, world's largest ICT companies. In Fortune Global 100, 80% actually choose our services, and we have over 105 billion in total revenue. And regarding NTT Communications, our headquarters are in Tokyo, Japan, and NTT Com is one of the leading cloud providers in Japan and one of the biggest data center operators in the world. Our services include data centers in over 140 countries and regions, VPN in over 196 countries, global tier one internet backbone, worldwide marine cable and IS and PAS services worldwide. And now, in what of our services do we actually use OpenStack? And so we use OpenStack in our service called NTT Communications Enterprise Cloud. It's mainly an IaaS, PaaS managed cloud. And the range of services that we give are actually including servers, storage, solution packages, which is mainly deployment services, and network security backup, app service, and management. And this is important in understanding our requirements for our service. So in the global market, NTT Communications Enterprise Cloud is actually available in 14 regions. And if you see the map, you can see the different regions where our service is available. And we have one more planned. And because we have so many regions, we have global affiliates like NTT America here in the US, NTT Europe, NTT Singapore, NTT Com Asia, NTT Com ICT, in this wide range, we have multiple support teams around the world and catering to multiple customers with multiple languages. So why do we use OpenStack? So we use OpenStack because it's open source, and because it is open source, it has a continuously expanding and active developer community. That's why we're all here in Austin attending this OpenStack Summit. And the version that we use is Juno, the 10th release. So if you look at this diagram, this is actually the summary of how we use OpenStack in our service. So if you look at the left side, that's the category of our service. And on the right side, you can see the legend, and the dark blue ones are the OpenStack components that we use. So we use Horizon, Keystone, Nova, Glance, and Cinder. On the other hand, the light blue ones are actually original components that we have developed ourselves, which are compatible or partially compatible with OpenStack API. Now, why not just use the original components of OpenStack? Why did we develop original components? It's because some original components of OpenStack actually do not meet the requirements of our service, and so we have to develop ourselves. This includes Nova-compatible bare metal servers, provisioned I/O block storage, and Neutron-compatible network, and Ceilometer-compatible as well. And on the other hand, we also have original components that are not compatible with OpenStack API, but we need them for our service, including solution packages, which including deployment services for SAP HANA and dedicated Hyper-V. Also regarding network, we have firewall, load balancer, VPN connectivity, and those things. And we also have user contract management with partner APIs. We actually provide this with Keystone. And we also provide this for our customers and sales partners as well. And we also have other open source software, which is Cloud Foundry. So this is important. The business background of our service, our main users are actually enterprise users. That's why enterprise public cloud environment. And however, there are actually gaps between the version of the OpenStack community and what actually the user wants. And so because of that, we have to establish the requirements of our service. And mainly, we have two requirements. The first is to support both traditional IT and cloud-native IT. And the second is to have a multi-customer and multi-tenant environment. And here is Koji to explain the first one.
Okay. From now, so let me explain to support traditional IT and the cloud-native ITs. So and traditional IT and the cloud-native IT can be explained through the pet versus cattle model analogy. At first, let's think about the pet model. So when you have a pet, such a cute dog.
Actually, he's my pet, and his name is Hu.
And you give a special name to your pet, like a Yuta, and when the pet gets sick, you nurse them back to your house, so you love so much pet, and it can be replaceable. On the other hand, the cattle is at cloud-native IT. So the cloud-native IT is designed for the cloud environment. So if the one VM gets get down, so basically that when you have a cow like this image, so it is difficult to distinguish by them by appearance. So you don't really give the name, you don't give attention to anyone of them. So it can be replaceable. So next, let's get it back to the traditional IT and cloud native IT, and. So, as far as the pet model, so pet model is like either traditional IT. And so some traditional IT users struggling to migrate their apps to cloud as a hypervisor requirement, as a new hypervisor, a new hardware, and in order to replacement of hardware. And but in order to reduce the cost of replacement of hardware, they would like to move cloud at first, cloud first. After that, they change the architecture for the cloud environment. After migrating the move to the cloud environment, however, if the traditional VM of the traditional IT apps get down, the end user and the VM of the VM the service of the traditional IT have been affected, and the service impact is great. So it means that the traditional users would like ES provider to recover the VM immediately. So it means that we, in order to support the traditional IT and the pet model, so we need to the traditional IT VMs should have a HA. So, and on the other hand, and the cattle model, and so cattle model is a cloud native IT. So cloud native IT is designed for the apps for the cloud architecture. So you mean that if one get VM down, it not be it would not be noticeable to the end user. So there's no almost no service impact. So in order to we need to support both traditional IT and cloud native IT. And to support the PET model, we need to implement the virtual machine hybridity we call the VMHA. VMHA is that, as you can see the below diagram, so the node VM on the computer node will be evacuated to the restarted in case of any failure. And so the reason why we VMHA required in enterprise public cloud is there's a two perspective. One is that which I mentioned in previous slide. So as a traditional ICT user, minimum I would like us as provider to minimize the impact of the traditional IT. And the other perspective is that the public ES provider. So they would like keep us. Public ES provider need to keep public ES working even if incident and outage occurs. So we need to implement a VMHA in OpenStack, but you know, so there is no VMHA function in the OpenStack Nova community. So the reason why VMHA is not in OpenStack Nova community is the implement the VMHA is to Nova doesn't match the content doesn't match the concept of Nova. So as you mean application should be changed cloud native architecture. So as a simple solution, so we can implement a VMHA function to Nova, but maintenance and operational costs increase. So it could a big barrier to it could create a big barrier for the OpenStack version upgrade. So we like to avoid the customs of Nova itself. So this is our solution. So we use a Masakari to realize the VMHA in OpenStack. The Masakari is an open source, which is originated the developed by NTT. And right now, so we can, if you want to use it, so you can download here to the URL. And we deploy the extra component, Masakari as an extra component and deploy it outside of OpenStack. So you mean that we don't need to modify open source code itself, OpenStack source code itself. And the Masakari also can meet our service requirement for the PET models and the CATO model. And Masakari, for the PET model, so Masakari can rescue the VM and work automatically. And the another CATO model, customer can choose not to use VMH function, which function is provided by Masakari. This is a simple architecture of the Masakari, and the technical key element is the Masakari, and that is a controller, and there's a controller and the agent. The Masakari controller is on the Masakari node, and also the Masakari agent is in each computer node, and a pacemaker and the crossing is required for each computer node. And the Masakari can rescue the VM, affected by the two case of incident. One is that the host down issue, and the another is a single down, VM down issue. So let's see the example of the each cases. The first is that the host down, the VM on the computer node 2, so gets host down. After that, another host K can detect the computer node number 2 down with pacemaker crossing. After that, Masakari agent notified the computer node number 2 down to Masakari controller, and then Masakari controller execute a recovery request to the mobile PI. So, and then VM, one VM3 will be evacuated to the computer node number 1. And as you can see, the computer node number 2, so there is a VM2 which have a no VM HF flag. So it is cloud native IT user, they deploy the VM into this node, and then that VM will not be evacuated to the another node. This is a host down issue. And the another case is that, let's see the other issues. It's a single VM down issue. Now, computer node number 3. So VM unintentionally get down on the computer node number 3, and then Masakari agent detects the VM down. And then Masakari controller, Masakari agent can detect the VM down and notify the single VM down to the, of the Masakari controller, and then recovery request executed. And then the VM will be rebuilt on the same node. So in order to support, by using the Masakari, so we use by using the Masakari, so we can support both traditional IT and the cloud native ITs. And so from now, let's go to the next topic. So next requirement, match customer, match tenant environment.
Okay, so since we provide an OpenStack as a IaaS and PaaS service for the customer as a public cloud, we have to support a multi-customer, multi-tenant environment in a same box. So here is an example. So as you can see, here is a one computer node. And one computer node, there is resource A, B, C, and which is owned by customer A and B and C. So in PET model, we needed to let customers know about the something happen to their resources, like, hey, your resource B goes down, like that. And to support this model, we need to have a way to find out a relationship between resource and the customer information. Like resource A is owned by customer A, and the customer A's mail address is blah, 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 like that. So this is a thing. And it's very simple use case. Here is a actual environment, which is more complicated. So on the left side, there is multiple customer has a colored by different color. And it means those kind of customer is supported by other support team. So there is some reason why we have a multiple support team. One is that the language is different. So we don't have a support team to support English, Japanese, and sometimes it's Spanish, like that. So to support this kind of use case, we divide a support team. And sometimes the region, like EU, have a regulation, like personal data protection regulation. So it means only the UK support team can access to the customer's personal data. So US and the EN support, and also JA, JP support shouldn't be able to access to their data. So this is a requirement. Also, in one computer node, sometimes there is a multiple tenants, which is owned by customer. And on the left side, as you can see, there is a firewall instance. So as Charles mentioned, we provide a firewall as a service. and which is built as a managed instance on a normal compute node, which is Innova. So in this case, this firewall instance is built on a compute node, which is same location in a with a customer, and which is owned by NTT Com, the tenant itself. So it means we cannot track the information based on the tenant's information. It's not enough. So this is a requirement. And here is the challenges. First challenge is that one incident could affect the multiple resources. So as I mentioned, in PET model, notification to the customer when an incident occurs is really important. So if something happen to the neutral network, it have a relationship with the Nova instance, right? So Nova instance network connectivity should be affected by this incident for neutral network. And also some other services, like bare metal server and NFS block storage, like that. So we need to let customer know about that, not only the network name, but also the related resources information. And it's much more complicated in multi-customer, multi-tenant environment, as I mentioned. And here is the other challenges. Yes, of course, we have a Masakari, as Koji mentioned, but Masakari VMHA itself sometimes causes a difficulty to track a customer information. So here is an example. Actually, the virtual resources is recovered by VMHA immediately, but actually it takes a time, something like 5 minutes, around 5 minutes like that. And actually, customer have been affected by this, so we need to let customer know about that. That is the same. And if something happen to the compute node too, in a right side, Masakari trying to move those VMs, which is in computer node 2, immediately moves to other host. In this case, computer node 1. But after it's evacuated, we don't have a way to which resources is in computer node 2. So it means we don't have a way to know which VMs have been affected by this incident. And also, sometimes you may know, sometimes failure sometimes may happen for evacuation itself. Evacuation itself could be failure. So in this case, we need a manual recovery. And of course, we can take the way to such a database, like connect with Nova and the Shindu and the Newton, trying to get those kind of relation map from a database. But it takes a time, and a lower tier engineer sometimes cannot do that. And the Masakari log just indicates the log of trigger for VMHA. So we sometimes miss the VM's location. So that could be a challenge for us. And one more thing here is that the OpenStack DB shows only the latest status of virtual resources. Like here is a use case. Sometimes customer asked about like, hey, my resources have been affected of something 1 day ago. But when we get that kind of inquiry, we don't have a way to know the virtual instance's status, which is in 1 day ago. So that could be a problem. OK, so let's move on to the solution for that. We have implemented two types of solutions as a one application. Which is called in called as an operation portal in our team, and this one have a two functionality. to support support engineers and also operation engineers. One is that resource state location history correction for multiple services. Here is a very simple description. We get the customer resources information from multiple OpenStack services DB or sometimes API every 5 minutes and correct that information to the resource history DB. And we provide the functionality to see that from operation portal, which is for operation and support engineers. So operation and support engineers can check the historical record of the VM's history and the location. That is one thing. And the other thing is that incident ticket association with resources information. So we handle the incident as a ticket to task, to manage that task. And we have a function, we implement the functionality to associate those affected resources and incident ticket. I will show that later. So this is a very general overview of the our solution. So let me jump into the solution one, resource state location history correction. We have a resource corrector in each region, and the corrector customers' resources information from OpenStack services within API or sometimes DB read. And we gather the, those kind of information in one location in each region, and we provide that to a functionality to check that from the GUI. And the corrected resources here is the corrected resources by resource corrector. It's just an example, but we're correcting the information from novel, like instance that table, and also instance metadata, aggregate metadata, and aggregate host. So to know the VM's current location, this kind of to correct the information from this kind of table is really help us a lot. And also Shindu and the Neutron, of course, some other services, we gather the information in one location. And here is a solution to the overview. All the information is associated with incident handling tickets. As I mentioned, we handle the incident with using the ticket system as a task management perspective. And we can put the affected resources from resource history database to incident tickets. And operator keep updating the incident tickets based on the latest information of incident handling. And here is the incident ticket overview. We have a data card, data cross, and effects for the resources and affected customer resources like that. So based on this ticket, our support and account manager, sometimes they got an inquiry from a customer, and they can handle that by themselves based on the latest operational information. And otherwise that, we have a functionality to send a bulk email notification to customer, like per customer. So it means we needed to put the each parameter, like, hey, your tenant A is goes down like that. But if we do that by manually, so it takes a lot of time. So we automate that functionality with based on the parameter function for the email notification. So here is the actual use case and the demo. Let me jump into the demo. So this is a very simple use case of the demo. First of all, suppose there is host down issue for the Nova computer node. We got alert from monitoring team, and also operator checks the hypervisor gets down, which hypervisor gets down, and check the which VM are affected. And basically, VMs are restarted automatically by VMHA massacre. So we don't need to anything based on that. And send an incident notification then, and send a recovery notification. Okay, let me jump into the demo. Okay, so here is our operation portals page, actual page. Here is the alarms, which comes from our monitoring system. And we have a functionality to multiple handling like this. And we can acknowledge or terminate those alerts to notify to our monitoring team, which is already handled by our operation team. And the one funny thing is that we have a functionality to put those alerts to the cart, like a web commerce site, like Amazon. So we can add that to the cart, and then we can associate those kind of alerts with the incident ticket. So let me go to the incident tickets page. Here is the incident tickets. We can check the all incident which is happening in our environment, and we control that from here. And we can check the incident detail from here. So here is the actual incident page, incident tickets. And here is the incident description. Of course, this is just a demonstration. It's a dummy data. But you can confirm when it's occurred and when it's recovered and the status, and also customer impact and the region, which services are affected by this incident, and also some note. So usually, our operator update this note for the latest information. And our support and support and account manager can confirm the latest status of the alert incident handling from here. And here is the associated alarms, which comes from our monitoring. So monitoring team can know about that, which alarm is already handled and which alarm is not handled. And we can put the affected resources to here, and then we can send a bulk notification from here. So this is actually group means our sales channel. We can send an email per sales channel, like in a different language or a different team. We have access restriction for that. So let me go to the resource correction database. So here is a page of the resource correction database. For here, we have a searching filters. So we can search by region, channel means sales channel, which we have, like America or JP, like that. And here is a contract ID and the tenant. And this is the thing, data and time. So if you put the date, which is before and now, you can see the historical information in that timing. So it helps us a lot to know the about the history of the VM status. And also here is the filters for resources. We usually use host names filter. So if something happens to the Nova computer node, we can search the affected resources from here. And also, here is the instance list, and here is the cinder volumes list. So we can check that and put into the cart also, and can do a shopping sometimes. Okay, so let me go back to the presentation. So finally, after create incident tickets, we can send an email for the customer. And based on the incident ticket's information, customer's notification is automatically filled out based on the information of in incident tickets. And here is an example. If we put a tenant.tenant ID, tenant ID per customer is shown on here, from the customer's perspective. And we can use if statement like velocity template. So it means in here, if customer have a VMs, this here virtual service part is shown for the customer's email. And if not, it's not shown on here. So it's very useful. And of course, we have a lot of challenges currently, furthermore. And one thing is that operations automation and handover to the lower tier engineers. We will have a plan to expand this portal to have a functionality to operate some of the operation like live migration and evacuation to the multiple customer resources. And yes, of course, we can do that from a CLI, but to hands-on to those tasks for more lower tier engineers, we should have that functionality on GUI. So we will implement that. And also, automate instant ticket creation and notification for customer with predefined pattern for known pattern instance. So since we expanded our services to US recently, we don't have not so much known pattern of that. Actually, US data center launch is the day before yesterday. And we will implement, automate that. And also, we will provide the functionality to check the instant handling status with sales partner. Because sometimes sales partner get the inquiry from their customer, and they would like to know the latest status of instant, including the internal information. So this is the plan. OK, so let me wrap up this session. We introduced our use case of OpenStack operation under multi-tenant and multi-customer public cloud environment. Hopefully, this use case and this presentation is useful for you guys also. Like if you operate this kind of complicated environment, or sometimes you want to get more reliability for virtual machine itself. And we achieved a quick notification to each customer and recovery VM affected by incidents with resource history correction, and also VMHA, which is Masakari. And we will keep contributing to OpenStack community with the feedback and sending patches to the community, and also this kind of knowledge sharing with the community in this summit. Right, that's all from us. Thanks for coming to this session. And if you have any question, please let us know.
Hi, good morning. In Masakari, using Pacemaker, the Herbit in a full mesh architecture, is there any scalability issues with the product?
Sorry, say again?
Is there any scalability issues with Masakari because of the full mesh Herbit that you are doing down there between the hypervisors?
Any issues? At this point, so we just release our services in this month, so we haven't get no specific incident with caused by the Masakari right now, but yeah. So at this point, no.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I think we can close this session. Thanks for coming.